Welcome back, dear children. Welcome back to the continuation class of World War One and its causes. Yeah, Balkan politics. Up to now, we discussed about aggression nationalism, followed by imperialism, followed by secret alliances, followed by militarism. Now we are going to discuss the fifth cause for World War One: Balkan politics. What is this Balkan Peninsula? Peninsula, you know, the landmass which is covered two sides by water. This is the Aegean Sea. Turkey, between Turkey and this Balkan region, Aegean Sea is there. Below Mediterranean Sea is there. And here Adriatic Sea is there. Adriatic Sea. So this is like India. This Balkan region is a Southeast European region where Greece, Macedonia, Bulgaria, Montenegro and Bosnia-Herzegovina. Bosnia-Herzegovina is one state only. Actually, Nana, Bosnia-Herzegovina, Croatia, Serbia, Slovenia. These are the four states. These after World War One became into Yugoslavia. And after World War II, also they continued up to 1991 as Yugoslavia. Then after they got broken again into Bosnia-Herzegovina, Serbia, Slovenia, Croatia. Got it? So these are the, but here in our history, Bosnia-Herzegovina and Serbia are very important out of the four states. I'll come across them. These are all called Balkan Peninsula, it is called. It was under control of Turkish Sultans. Muhammad II put it there in the previous video. I mentioned it. In 1453, one fellow by name Muhammad II, the Sultan of Turkey, occupied Constantinople and he got now presented as Istanbul, and which is a land link between Europe and Asia, and he stopped European centering into Asia. From that time onwards, that Islamic rule started being on this Balkan states. What it was? Greece, Macedonia, Bulgaria, Serbia, Bosnia and Herzegovina, and so on. Right? So, here what is the problem? The people in these countries are following Christian faith. They are Christians. And the ruler is Muslim, Islamic rule. According to the Sharia, Islamic law, the rule was. So there was constant conflict between the subjects means people of Balkan region and the ruler. But ruler being powerful used to suppress the revolting voices or raising voices for a long time. But from 1912, the story changed. 1912 October, first Balkan War occurred. First Balkan War, Bulgaria, Greece, Bosnia-Herzegovina, Serbia, Macedonia, Montenegro, these are all countries fought against the ruler. Actually, these countries are not having that military strength now. Russia is the top of this. This is Russia. Russia is having a strong military strength now. At that time. And Russia supported these countries. What is the reason Russia supporting these countries? That is, there are a community people called Slavs in Serbia, Bosnia-Herzegovina. What it is? Slavs, S-L-A-V-S, Slavs. And these Slavs have relationship with, or kinship with, Slavs of Russia. These Slavs have relationship with the Slavs of Russia. Kinship means their forefathers belong to Russia. They came and settled down over here. And so that way they are related. So as these people are Slavs, Russia started showing some favor to them, and these people started taking support of Russia. And when Russia started supporting them, Turkey got the support of the neighboring country of Bosnia and Herzegovina, Austria, and also Hungary. Hungary. So these two, Austria and Hungary, Everybody understand? In Balkan War One. Balkan War One occurred from October 1912 to June 2013. Sorry, 1913. Make a point. June 1913. Almost all some 88 or something like that. But it and second Balkan War occurred from June to July. Why these two Balkan Wars? In first Balkan Wars, with all countries with the support of Russia revolted very strongly. Other than Macedonia, remaining all states declared their independence by defeating the army of Turkish Sultan. Or Turkish Empire is called Ottoman Turkish Empire. Ottoman is the dynasty that ruled Turkey. Dynasty, Wamsa. Got it? That ruler, Turkey, that's why Turkey is, Turkish Empire is called as Ottoman Turkish Empire. But Muhammad 1 to Muhammad 6. This revolution of Balkan states took place during the time of Muhammad 6. Got it? Last ruler, Ottoman dynasty ruler of Turkey. So, later Turkey becomes a republic after World War I. Right, that's a different story. Yeah, Turkey. These Balkan states fought against them. First war, Balkan War occurred 1912 October to June 1913. And very next month, second Balkan War occurred, that is June to July. Why? All states other than Macedonia got freed. So these states again contemplated, took a vote that we will make even Macedonia free from Turkish control. Because if one country, Macedonia, is there in between them and it is under control of Turkey, Turkey can create a problem again. That's why in June to July they waged a war, once one more war, that's Balkan War number 2. So because of this constant struggle between Balkan states and Turkish rulers, that area turned into a tinder box, Agnigunda. What it, that region turned into a tinder box. Constantly struggling there. Some one or other violent activity is going on. So, finally by 1913, these Balkan states became independent. Once they became independent, Austria could not tolerate it. Why? Because Austria self-declared according to 1878 Berlin Congress, these are my parts. But with the help of Russia, they started what we can call fighting against Turkey, and they became liberated, independent. Austria tried to establish its control, and it was to a certain extent it was successful in establishing its control upon Bosnia and Herzegovina. So Bosnia and Herzegovina went under control of them, but Serbia did not go under control of Austria. And in 1908, there came a prince to the throne of what we can call Austria, Franz Ferdinand. 1908, he became prince of Austria. This Ferdinand, this fellow, started moving to that immediate cause. Immediate cause we are entering into. This Austrian prince started going in the capital of Bosnia and Herzegovina. Please remember, it is not, don't pronounce it as Sarajevo. Sarajevo is wrong. Sarajevo, J silent, Sarajevo. S-A-R-J-E-V-O. But J should be silent as Sarajevo. Is the right pronunciation, Bosnia and Herzegovina. Right? So, Austrian Crown Prince, in this way, when this Balkan politics, the states fighting against Turkey, Russia trying to establish control upon Austria, trying to establish control upon the Balkan region after they became independent, this created a big tense and that region turned into a tinderbox before World War I. And what is the immediate cause is, I said, you know, Franz Ferdinand became Crown Prince of Austria in 1908. This man in 1914, on 28th June 1914, this gentleman started moving in capital of Bosnia and Herzegovina, Sarajevo. Sarajevo he was moving in a coach, horse coach. You know, horse coach. What it? So they are moving. This fellow along with his wife Sophia, Ferdinand along with his wife Sophia is moving in, but a horse coach in a city, capital city of Bosnia Herzegovina. Bosnia Herzegovina, one country only. It's not two. Bosnia Herzegovina, not different. Right. In Sarajevo, what happened is Bosnian Serbia, Serbian community fellow, our fellow belonging to Serbia, who is living in Bosnia, is called Bosnian Serbian. That fellow's name is Principal. What is the name of the fellow? Principal. Principal and Mr. Serbsel. Serbsel are deadly against Austria, which is trying to establish its control even on their own motherland, Serbia. Already it established its control upon Bosnia and Herzegovina, and it is trying to establish its control upon Serbia. This is much to the dislike of Serbians. That's why a Serbian who is living in Bosnia and Herzegovina, Sarajevo, by name Principal, he opened fire upon Ferdinand, the Crown Prince of Austria, and his wife Sofia, both were assassinated, killed on the spot. And this was taken as a shock by Austria. And immediately Austria issued an ultimatum to Serbia that that fellow belongs to your country. Bosnia warned even Serbia and Bosnia Herzegovina. Within 48 hours, that fellow had to be caught. If not, you have to face dire consequences. Warning, ultimatum was given by Austria too, because it lost its crown prince, who will have to carry the administration for some coming 4 or 5 decades. That fellow passed away, and there is no successor. So Austrian king was very strong against this, and he warned. But Bosnia and Serbia, they did not care. They paid a deaf ear. Why? Because, and of course, they may be small countries, but they are at the back, there is a big Dara. Bahubali is standing at the back, neither in Russia. And Russia already had a friendship with France, England. They became triple entity. Whereas Germany, Austria, and Italy became triple aliens. And whereas France, England, Russia became triple entity. Triple entity, E-N-T-E-T-E. Entity, triple entity. So there are big. Bahubali is standing at the back. This fellow did not care. Austria is going on, hey, you have to listen to me. If not, I'll see your end. All these sort of things are going for 1 month now. 28th June 1914, Ferdinand and his wife got murdered by a person himself called Princip. Ferdinand and his wife Sophia got murdered. And for 1 month, Austria is going on, warning. But this fellow, Bosnia Herzegovina, either Bosnia Herzegovina or Serbian rulers did not care, they did not pay any attention to. So now, after 1 month, 28th July 1940, Austria lost all its patience and carried an attack against Bosnia and Herzegovina and Serbia. And when Austria attacked 28th July, this is an attack made between two European countries, one being in the west and other being in the east. The attack was between two countries. It is a small flake of fire. Soon it turned into a big flame. Why? Because by 1st August, a world war broke. First world war where most of the world countries got involved happened by 1st August. This small war between two small countries turned into a world war by 1st August 1914. Why? When Austria attacked Bosnia and Herzegovina, Serbia, Russia came to the rescue of Austria. And in meeting the Russia, if they ask them to get after Russia, Germany and Russia knows if it touches Austria, Germany, its friend Germany will not leave. Got it? That's why Russia put its troops towards Germany also. And Germany will be quiet. Germany will be quiet. No, because some enemy's army is coming towards my boundary, will we be quiet? Chinese entered, intruded into our domain near Ladakh. Did we keep quiet? Our army, they protested, of course, our 20 Indian army crew got lost their valuable lives for the sake of Mother India. Of course, that some 20 or 30 of China also got killed. No problem with that. So, no country will accept someone coming.
Then Russia moved. Why Russia?
Russia anticipated.
If I am touching Austria,
surely Germany comes into war. Why we should give chance to Germany?
We will attack Germany also. It is started sending its army to Austria and also towards
Germany. Once Germany got attacked, Germany will not keep quiet.
Germany started attacking.
On one hand, it is fighting with Russia. And when it is fighting with Russia, below Germany, there is France.
There is France. France already waiting like Kattappa.
Already waiting like Kattappa to take revenge.
Or to take revenge against Germany.
And it is started attacking France. Now France is waging war with two hands. That is, on one hand countering Russia, the other hand it is countering France, Germany. Germany started fighting and France's friend England came.
Who came? England. Here it is. They are a part of England. Even England started launching attack upon
Germany. Germany, Vishu doing on all, very strongly it is fighting against these people. And Italy, who promised to be in triple alliance along with Germany and Austria, it acted as a gopi. Gopi means Godwin village, jumped to the other side and joined with the triple entente.
Italy. It also started attacking Germany and Austria.
It also started attacking Germany and Austria, which was a friend in 1882, turned enemy and started attacking Austria and Germany. In this way, all sort, because Germany is having a strong military power, everyone targeted Germany. And war at the initial, this group of German, led by Germany is called Central Powers.
Group led by Germany is called Central Powers. Germany, Austria are one front of the,
they all are one front. They all are Hungary, Austria, Turkey, Germany are one group. They are Central Powers.
Germany, the leader of Central Powers is Germany. And the group led by England.
England is the leader.
Russia, France,
and Bosnia and Herzegovina and so on, they are called Allied Powers.
Allied Powers are headed by England.
Elite wars are headed by England. A big war started. When these countries started fighting, Nana, colonies of France in Africa, colonies of England in Africa, Germany, Belgium, all started coming into action. Asian colonies of France, Britain, even India also fought on behalf of England, elite wars in World War I, because we are under control of Britain. In this way, all world countries got dragged into the war, failed by first MS, then it turned into a world war, first world war. And up to 1917, Central Powers were terrific, they were having upper hand. But in 1917, what happened? Because of its internal revolution, Russia, who is a cause for the second first world war, could not go ahead. And it got shown a white kerchief to Germany. So, like a friend, I can't fight. And Germany said, okay, boss, you want to leave the war field, I'll permit you. But what is to me, what is the benefit to me? Then Russia gave six states which are to the west of the
western part of Russia, where the states are there.
Though the states are called Lithuania, Livonia, Estonia, Ukraine, these are the states, Finland
is one of them here, on the top of Europe. Here, it is Finland, this is Finland, close to Russia, Finland, and beside Germany is Poland. Finland, Poland, and four states below Russia.
What are they? Lithuania, Livonia, Estonia, Ukraine. Four states belonging to Russia, and also two which are under control of it, Finland and Poland. All six states were given to Germany in 1917 by Russia, and a treaty was signed. Name of the treaty is Brest-Litovsk Treaty.
That name of 1917 is a treaty was signed between Russia and Germany. That is Brest-Litovsk,
Brest-Litovsk Treaty.
Brest-Litovsk Treaty. So you can understand
how dominant the Central Powers and Germany were in the initial stages of First World War. And with that treaty, Russia got withdrawn from the war field. And when Russia went out, immediately America jumped into war field. Why America jumped into the war field on behalf of Allied powers? It identified. It was quiet. When World War I started and it is happening, America was silent. But once it observed Germany's ferocious fight, how strong like Bahubali it is fighting, if we don't enter into the war, it will be going to be a danger to the world. And also, meanwhile, what happened is Germany targeted a cargo ship of America. Cargo means which will carry goods. Any ship which carries goods is called vessel. V-E-S-S-E-L, vessel. So name of that ship is Lusitania. Lusitania, a cargo carrying Lusitania, L-U-S-I-T-A-N-I-A, Lusitania. It's not a military ship, but Germany suspected that it is a military ship and it attacked. Once Lusitania, which is a goods carrying ship of America, got attacked, America jumped into the warfield. Once America stepped into the warfield, once I step in, history changes. History changes, right? What happened? The downtrend of Central Powers started. The downtrend of Central Powers started, and by next year, 11th November 1918, all what, without saying to Germany, its friends, Turkey surrendered, Austria surrendered, and foolishly Germany is alone fighting. But Allied powers are very powerful and has one fight on 11th November 1918. Germany signed an armistice, armistice. That is, any country before withdrawing from a war field, it gives an assurance that some loss will be paying, whatever the loss happened to this war and all. That with that assurance, it will be withdrawing. Like how Russia gave the six states to Germany in 1917 when it got withdrawn from the war. Able to understand, ma? Now you have to understand treaty, PACT pact, ACCORD accord in history. These all mean same thing, agreement. Agreement that happens between one country and other country. Pact, treaty, accord, ACCORD, open them. Right? Thank you all. Here we conclude causes of World War I. Hope this class will be entertaining you, educating you, and entertaining you well. And we will meet in the next video with the Treaty of Versailles, the agreement signed after World War I, before the Paris Peace Conference. Apart from that, League of Formation of First Two Peacekeeping Body, League of Nations, and so on, in the coming video. Thank you all. See you.